Hi friends, welcome to another short demonstration of a laparoscopic procedure. So today I will discuss how to efficiently close a vaginal vault using laparoscopic technique. I will also try to discuss all the simpler ways of performing laparoscopic vault suturing, so stay tuned. So before actual starting your laparoscopic vault suturing, you should see that you have a clear vaginal vault margin of at least 1 cm anteriorly, which is free of any bladder fiber. So as you can see in this video, I am using needle holder to push all the bladder fibers that might come in my way while performing laparoscopic vault suturing. This can be very efficiently performed using needle holder, but again, you can use your instrument of choice. Many people I have seen perform it using suction or scissor or whichever instrument you are comfortable with. You can also use a plain grasper if you want. The motive is to avoid including bladder fibers into your vault suturing. So you can see how smoothly the bladder fibers are getting pushed downwards just by a gentle traction. Once you get rid of all the bladder fibers out of your way, then you can perform or you can start performing your laparoscopic vault suturing. So again, there are 2-3 ways of inserting your thread along with needle inside the abdominal cavity. People use vaginal route to introduce it inside, but it has a theoretical risk of carrying your vaginal infection inside the peritoneal cavity. So then how to introduce thread inside the abdominal cavity? I would always prefer putting it through one of my ports. So now I have one 10 mm port and other 5 mm ports. So fortunately, needle along with thread can be easily passed inside the abdominal cavity through a 5 mm port. Also, if you are not well versed with this, you can always insert it through 10 mm camera port. So here you can clearly see how a needle can easily be passed along with its thread through a 5 mm port. Now comes the most important part, grasping the needle. So always remember, it is a two-step technique. Catch hold of the tip of the needle and hold your needle at 2/3, 1/3. Entire suturing should be performed by a swift action of your wrist joint. Now let's start the actual vault closure. Now lift your anterior vault using your grasper or ask your assistant to help you in that and take a good bite using your needle. Here I am performing a vault closure using simple Vicryl 10. V-lock or quill is also a popular suture to perform this laparoscopic vault closure. You can see here I have already asked my assistant to put a knot and form a loop at the end of my Vicryl, just as in case of V-lock, which will save me some time and is equally effective. So you should always keep in your mind while performing vault closure that you have to close the vault. Also, you have to prevent future vault prolapse. So how to prevent future vault prolapse? So basically, you should include uterosacral ligaments into your vault closure. Also, anteriorly, the paracervical fascia should be involved in your vault suture. So here you can clearly see my first bite has included right-sided uterosacral ligament, and now I am tightening the knot. Again, you can see how to catch hold of the needle. You can hold the tip of needle using your left-handed instrument, and using your needle holder, you can hold the needle at the junction of 2/3, 1/3. Now again, there are 2-3 ways of performing laparoscopic vault suturing. You can either close vault by taking continuous sutures or by interlocking sutures as well. I believe in taking all interlocking sutures because they are hemostatic as well. Don't forget to include paracervical fascia anteriorly and peritoneum posteriorly. Paracervical fascia definitely has a proven role in preventing future vault prolapse. Peritoneum per se is not important for preventing future vault prolapse, but it decreases bleeding by pressure effect, and also it will reduce the raw surface area, which will further decrease the adhesions. So now you can ask your assistant to hold the thread and lift the vault, which will make your job easy. This is entirely an unedited video of laparoscopic vault suturing, which is purely made for the teaching purpose and to make everyone understand the easiest way of performing laparoscopic vault suturing. Now moving on to the last and the final stitch of vault suturing. Many of the times the opposite sided edge of the vault gets dragged downwards because of the approximation of the vault by interlocking or continuous suturing. So you can simply lift the angle of opposite sided vault by your grasper and take a bite. Most importantly, do not forget to take a bite through utero-sacral ligament. So on one side I used a loop just as that of V-lock or quill to tie a knot. So on this opposite side I will demonstrate how to tie the knot. So first step is to form a C. You can see here clearly I have formed a C. Then I will pass my instrument through it twice, and then I will hold the loop which was left for grasping and I will tie the knot. Few people also make a good use of curvature of needle to form a loop around their needle holder or a grasper before they hold the other sided loop, or also I have seen so many people perform it the other way around. They will hold the thread in with the right handed instrument and they will rotate it around the left handed instrument. So you should always follow whichever technique you feel is good for you. Now I am forming another C and I am passing my instrument through it before I hold the other sided loop, and then I am pushing my loop downwards, and this is it. This is my final knot. There is no added advantage of putting more than two knots for vault suturing. Now your assistant will pass scissor through one of his ports and he will cut your thread. Do not forget to open the loops as the omentum or the bowel might get stuck in it. As soon as you are done with your vault suturing, ask your assistant to form a solution of methylene blue, and you can pass it in a retrograde fashion through the catheter into the bladder. It will help you identify bladder injuries, and if at all you identify bladder injuries, proceed with bladder repair then and there itself. I put around 300 to 400 cc of methylene blue solution inside the bladder. Here you can see clearly how the bladder is getting filled, and still there is no spillage of methylene blue. So now we can rest assured that we have not damaged bladder during our total laparoscopic hysterectomy or the procedure of laparoscopic vault suturing. Irrigation and suction is a must before you end your procedure. Thank you.